Hoping to attract Nurgle's aid in preventing a cure for plague, the Wurmspat are resolved to undo this cure and continue spreading filth for their beloved deity. In this video, we're going to share how to paint one of these models from the Wurmspat warband, and we're going to be painting the sorcerer Fecula Flyblown. However, by following this guide, you can easily paint any other member of a warband. So when you're ready, grab those brushes, shake those paints, and let's get started. Before we begin painting, the first thing we need to do is undercoat the model. And as you can see here, I've used Death Guard Green, which is perfect for all the colours we're going to be applying in this Nurgle-based video. And the first colour we're going to be applying is Creed Camo, which is a contrast. So I'm just going to give it a quick shake, get that pot open like so, and then we're ready to start applying that. So we're coating this on the green cloth and the green armour. I'm going to use a medium layer brush for this, just for a bit of neatness, so I don't go too mad when applying it. So I'm applying it to the palette. Now this is more just so I don't overload the brush. I'm not thinning it down at any point with this particular part. So I get my brush to a nice point like so, and then we're ready to start applying that to the cloth and the armour. Also, it is worth noting, I've not glued the retchling down, so actually if I need to, I can just spin it out of the way when I start painting areas in these details here. First of all, let's just start applying Creed Camo to the cloth. There we are with the Creed Camo now dry. What we're going to do now is move on to using Death Guard Green. This is more of a tidy stage, so some of those raised areas, like the folds of the cloth, we're just going to reapply like as a layer or even a highlight in some of those little torn areas. So I'm just going to use a medium layer brush for this, apply a little bit to the palette. Again, I'm only adding a touch of water just so it's not too thick and goopy. Make sure I get a nice point to my brush, and then we're ready to start doing that tidy up stage. So all I'm going to do, if you look at the cloth here, just some of those raised areas, just start moving up like a highlight. Start tidying that up. And if you've got like little tears as well, just can work around. It's like a thicker, chunkier highlight, ready for when we do the next stage. Just work all the way around the model doing the same thing. There we are with those Death Guard Green areas now tidied up or highlighted. We're going to move on to using Nurgling Green as a highlight as well. So I'm just going to get my brush again, get a nice point to it. So first of all, just apply a little bit to the palette, not too much. Again, this is just so I can roll it around and get a nice point to my bristles. And all we're doing here is doing a fine highlight around those folds and edges. So all I'm going to do is just start on that little tear there and just do a nice little highlight. Keep doing it around all those areas you just highlighted or tidied up previously. And if you do make any mistakes, just use some Death Guard Green to tidy back up. There we are with those highlights now done. What we're going to do now is move on to adding a little bit more definition into some of those folds, because sometimes you don't always notice it when you're doing the first few highlights. So we're going to use Creed Camo again just to add a little bit more depth to some of the lower parts of those folds. So what I'm going to do is grab my brush again, just apply a little bit to the palette, get a nice point to the brush, and then we're ready to start applying it. So what I'm going to do is just start dropping it into some of those deeper recesses, just mainly at the bottom of the folds, like so, and just run it down into those cracks. And sometimes where you've got like some of the holes or tears, you can just add a little bit more in there as well. There we are with all the green cloth now done. We're going to move on to the next area, which is to paint the brown leather. Now for this, we're going to start with a base coat of Mornfang Brown. We're then going to apply a contrast of Gorgrunter Fur all over. We're then going to highlight using Scrag Brown. And then after that, we'll be using Carrot Stone as a final highlight. But first of all, let's start applying that base coat of Mornfang Brown. I'm just going to open the pot, pop a little bit in, apply it to the palette, little touch of water, and then we're ready to start. So you've got just a tabard on the front here and also the bit around the back there as well. So I'm just going to start by base coating that. With our base coat now applied, we're going to use Gorgrunter Fur. I'm going to apply it all over those brown areas we just painted. Try not to overload your brush too much because it can quickly run out of control. So just take your time, don't overload it, get a nice point to it. If you do find the actual contrast spilling out anywhere, just mop it up with your brush and then just tidy back up with any paint that you need to. Another thing to bear in mind as well, if you do splodge on areas that have not been painted yet, don't worry about that because you'll be painting those later. There we are, the contrast now applied and dry. We're going to start doing our first highlight using Scrag Brown. So all we're doing here is just looking around to highlight those edges and just around the tears as well. In most places, you can just use the edge of the brush like I'm doing here. But in some places, you might just have to use the tip. So just make sure you get a nice fine point when you're doing that. With our first highlight now done, we're going to move on to the next highlight, which is a finer highlight, and for this we're using Carrick Stone. So the idea here is just to make this a bit finer, so you can still see some of that Scrag Brown showing through. So take your time, just work your way around. If you make any mistakes, just tidy back up with one of the previous paints that you might have splodged onto. There we are, now that we've highlighted the brown leather areas, we're going to move on to our next area, which is to start painting the skin details, the meaty bits, the tentacles, as well as the bandages and straps on the model. Now for this, we're going to be using Rakar Flesh. So what I'm going to do is grab my medium layer brush. Just going to apply a little bit to the palette like so, little touch of water so it's not too thick and goopy. Get a nice point to our brush, and then we're ready to start painting. So there's quite a few areas on the model. You've got the face, you've got the arms and tentacles around here. You've also got like some haunches of meat around the back. There's lots of meat exposed or flesh on the tears of the cloth, and also the little retinue in the front here as well as bits. So I'm just going to start on an arm and work my way around. If you're not sure, just check the box art for details. There we are, with all those skin areas and straps and bandages now base coated with Rakar flesh. What we're going to do now is move on to applying some other colours. We're going to start by using contrast paint, which is Gulliman flesh. We're going to thin this down with contrast medium. After that, we'll do the same thing using Vlupus pink, just to add a bit of like pinkiness to the tentacles and some of the meaty bits. After that, we'll then tidy back up with Rakar flesh, finish off with a highlight of Pallid Witch flesh. But first of all, let's start applying that contrast medium to the Gulliman flesh. So all I'm going to do is get two dollops of contrast medium, just place them now on the palette like so, and then one dollop. Gulliman flesh. Just mix it together. This will give it a slightly paler skin than what you'd be using if you just did it straight from the pot. So once I've loaded my brush up, I'm ready to start applying that to all the skin areas. So we're just keeping this to the skin. So the straps, like the bandages on the staff, you won't be applying it there. If you do get it on there by accident, just tidy back up with Rakar flesh. With the Gulliman flesh now dry, we're going to do the same mix using Vlupus pink, and we're just going to apply this just to the tentacles. So starting from probably like halfway, working your way up, then a bit more to the tip like so. Also any meaty bits as well, like this haunch of meat on the back, just cover that just so it looks a bit grim and horrible. So just apply that like so. With the Vlupus pink now dry, what we're going to do is start using Rakar flesh as a layer and a highlight. In some places we'll do an edge highlight, in other places we'll just layer up. And finally, we're going to highlight with Pallid Witch flesh. So this is just a little highlight on some of those key areas where the light will touch. So things like knuckles, little joints, maybe some of the little spiky bits on the tentacle. There we are with the flesh bits now done. We're going to move on to the next area, which is to paint the skull, horns and bone. So for this, we'll be starting with a base coat of Morgas bone. After that, we'll be using a contrast of Skeleton Horde. Then on the tips of the bones and the horns, we'll be using Cygore Brown. Then we'll finish off with a highlight of Pallid Witch flesh. But first of all, let's start with the Morgas bone. So we're just going to apply that to the palette like so. Just a little touch, a little bit of water so it's not too thick and goopy. Get a nice point to the brush. And then we're ready. So I'm just going to start on the crown around the head. So I've already base coated previously with Rakar flesh one part, but this one is going to be with Morgas bone, like so. And don't forget, you've got a few skulls scattered around the model, and also the bones, or the horn, should I say, on the little retchling on the base as well. So don't forget to do that. Now that our base coat's done, we're going to use Skeleton Horde to start applying that over all the bone details, including the skulls, as well as the horns. And I've also picked out his little toenails as well. So it's worth doing those too. Once the skeleton horn's dry, we're now going to use Cygore Brown just to go on the tips of the horns, just to make it a little bit darker. So only probably like the top quarter of a horn. Don't have to go too mad. With the Cygore Brown now dry on the tips of those horns, we're just going to move on to applying Pallid Witch flesh just to the tips of some of those areas of the horns, just where the light will catch. So you don't have to go too mad. And same for like the skull cheeks and definition around the eye sockets as well. Now all those bone details are done, we're going to move on to the next area, which is to paint the wood on the staff. So for this, we're going to start with a base coat of Steel Legion Drab. We're then going to shade it with Agrixur Shade and finish off with a highlight of Carrick Stone. First of all, let's start with the Steel Legion Drab. Again, as always, just apply a little bit to the palette, a little touch of water, get it to a nice point, and then we're ready to start. So what I'm going to do, like I said, I'm just picking out all the woody areas on here, so I'm going to start at the tip and just work my way down. Again, if you do splodge, don't worry, just tidy back up with those previous paints. With the wood of the staff now base coated, we're going to move on to applying Agrixur Shade to that wood. Try not to overload your brush as it might run out of control and start spreading on other areas, so just be mindful of that. And if it does happen, just use your brush to soak up any excess. Once the shade's dry, we're ready to then start highlighting with Carrack Stone. So for this, I'm just going to start running around where some of the grain is or some of those raised areas on the actual woodwork itself. Again, don't go too mad, just peck out the odd little bit here and there. There we are with the wooden staff now done. We're going to move on to the next area, which is to paint the bandages. Now for this, we've already base coated those areas with Rakar flesh. So the first thing we're going to do is use Creed Camo thinned down with contrast medium. Probably two parts contrast medium to one part Creed Camo. After that, when necessary, we'll tidy back up or re-highlight with Rakar flesh and then finish off with a highlight of Pallid Witch flesh. But first of all, let's start with that Creed Camo. So what I'm going to do is get a couple of dollops of contrast medium like so, and then just a dollop of Creed Camo. Apply that in there. This is really just to make it look like the bandages have started to seep some of that rot through. So it gives it a kind of a rotten look to it, which is nice for Nurgle. So what we're going to do is start picking those out. So you've got bandages here, you've got a bit just around his wrist and some on his feet as well. With that contrast paint now dry, what we're going to do is just tidy back up in some areas using Rakar Flesh. So on some of the actual bandage, just a little bit here and there. Now I've also picked out these horns in the same way as well, so I'm just going to start tidying around some of the edges of those as well. There we are, with a tidy up of Rakar Flesh done, we're now just going to finish off with a little highlight of Pallid Witch Flesh here and there. With the straps and bandages now done, we're going to move on to painting the rusty metal. Now for this we're going to start with Ironhand Steel as a base coat, we're then going to use Agraxir Shade as a shade and finish off with a highlight of Stormhost Silver. So first of all, let's get that base coat on. So as always, just a dollop of water added to that paint, get a nice point to the brush, and then we're ready. Now there's a few little details of metal on this, so you've got like a little star on here, he's also got a little dagger at the back. So again, just study the model, if you're not sure, check the box art. With the base coat applied, we're now going to apply Agraxir shade to all those metal areas. With the shade dry, we're now going to highlight using Stormhost Silver. Again, just picking out those edges where possible. If you see any rivets or little dots, just pick those out too. There we are, with those silver areas now done, we're going to move on to picking out the breast details. And for this one, we start with Balthazar Gold as a base coat, and then going to shade it with Agraxir shade, and then finish off with a highlight of Stormhost Silver. But first of all, let's begin that base coat. So I'm just going to apply a little bit to my palette, a little touch of water, get to a nice point, and then we're ready to start. So I'll just start on the eight-pointed star on the shoulder pad. So all I'm going to do is just slowly pick that out. You've also got the belt to do up here as well. With the base coat applied, we're now just going to run some Agraxir shade over. So again, take your time. If you do splodge, just tidy back up after. And there we are. To finish off the brass, we're just going to highlight that up with Stormhost Silver as well. Dab a little bit on the rivets and on some of the other harder edges. There we are, with the brass details now done, we're going to move on to painting the black areas. So this is the hair and the leather. Now I'm going to start by base coating all the details with Abaddon Black. After that, we'll start highlighting the leather with Cabalite Green, followed with Saberite Green. And then after that, we'll move on to the hair and highlight this with Demonette Hide, and then follow that with Slash Grey. But first of all, we'll start base coating all the black details first. So I'm just going to get Abaddon Black onto the palette like so, with a little touch of water, and we're ready to start. So like I said, you've got the hair to do, and also we've got like a little bit of baggage around, so you've got a pouch here, and if we just turn it around, there's a couple of little straps and more bags there. So let's just start there. With all those black areas now base coated, we're going to start with the highlight of the leather. The first one is going to be Cabalite Green, and we're going to make this fairly chunky when we start going around those leather areas. Using Cabalite Green as well is going to give it more of a sickly kind of greeny black kind of feel to it. With that first highlight down, we're now going to move on to using Saberite Green as the final highlight for that black leather. So again, you want to make this a little bit thinner than the first one, just so you can see both bits showing through to give it a nice gradient. Just take your time, work on those edges. There we are, the black leather now highlighted, we're going to move on to the hair. For this, we'll be starting with Demonette Hide. So all I'm going to do is try and get the brush at an angle, just start using the side of the brush to actually start doing those first strands. Now for the most of it, you're just going to be coating over on the raised bits for the hair, like so. Concentrate more at the bottom of the hair than at the top, so it should be darker at the top than it is at the bottom. So just take your time. If you do make any mistakes, tidy back up with Abaddon Black. With that first highlight done, we're now going to move on to applying Slaanesh Grey. We're just going to keep this to the tips of the hair and mainly toward the bottom. There we are, with the hair now highlighted, we're going to move on to painting the pustules. For this, we're going to start with Avalon Sunset as a base coat. We're then going to shade or add some contrast around the edges of Volupus Pink to give it that horrible soreness effect, and finish off with a highlight of Morgast Bone. So first of all, let's start with the base coat. So I'm just going to apply a little bit to the palette, a little touch of water, and we're ready to start picking out. There's quite a few on the model, so just take your time and study the model, and then just pick them out when you see them. So we've just got the one here on the shoulder pad, and there's a few on the tentacles, and also on his little retchling beast as well. With the pustules now base coated with Avalon Sunset, we're going to run some Volupus Pink just around the edges. This will give it that nice sore effect, so it looks like they're just ready to pop. With the Volupus Pink now applied to the surrounding areas of the pustules, we're just going to finish off with a highlight of Morgast Bone, which should give it a nice sort of creamy, ripened look to those pustules. There we are, with those pustules completed, what we're going to do now is move on to the next area, which is to paint the green skin of the wretchling. Now, at this point, you would have already painted the flesh areas, the bone areas, and the pustule areas as we've been going along doing the rest of the model. So what we're going to do now is obviously just concentrate on the green part of the body. So I'd recommend just tidying back up with a bit of Death Guard green before you start doing this, just to make sure it's nice and neat. So what we're going to do is start off by using orc flesh. Now, as this is a contrast paint, so I'm going to apply it all over those green areas. Once that's dry, we're going to do a second coat, just concentrate this from like the knees onwards down, so like round his ankles and feet. And when that's done, I'm going to finish off with a highlight of Nurgling Green. But first of all, let's start with that first contrast. So I'm using it straight from the pot, but I am just going to add it to the palette. Again, this is more just so I don't overload my brush too much. So once I've done that, we're ready to start applying it to the Wretchling. So as you can see here, all those other areas are already coated on it, so I'm just going to concentrate on those green areas. And the best thing as well, as I remember saying earlier, that just make sure that you don't obviously glue it in or anything like that, so you can spin it around so you can get around to the other side as well. Just makes it a lot easier. With that first coat now dry, what we're going to do is apply a second coat of orc flesh, but we're going to, like I say, from the knee downwards. Just this will make it look a little bit darker and give it a bit of a gradient as well. So just do a coat of that and then let that dry as well. There we are, with the orc flesh now applied to the lower part of the body, what we're going to do now is to start highlighting the skin up. And for this we're using Nurgling Green. So I'm just going to find out where those little bits of muscle are and just start doing some nice little highlights around it, picking things like the knee as well. There we are, with the Wretchling skin now done. What we're going to do now is move on to the final detail of this model, and that's to paint its base. So we're going to start by base coating the stone using Mechanica Standard Grey. So what I'm going to do is grab my medium layer brush for this. Just going to apply a little bit to the palette as always, a little touch of water, and then we're ready to start base coating. So all I'm going to do is get a nice point to that, and all we're going to do is start picking out those details on the base. Now you've got a couple of little stones around there as well, so pick those out, and where need, just move them out of the way to get into some of those more tighter cracks and crevices. There we are, with the stonework now done, what we're going to do now is move on to adding some texture to the base, and for this we'll be using Stirling mud. So I'm going to grab my trusty texture tool and use the large scoop side first. So I'm just going to get some of that on that like so, and then I'm ready to dollop that onto the top of the base. So you can see there's some texture there. If you want to, you can paint it, but I'm actually just going to add some of this Stirling mud because it looks cool. So what I'm going to do is move some of that around like so, then move to the smaller side just for a bit more accuracy. So what I'm going to do is start doing that. Now once I've done this area around here, I'll just quickly move that Wretchling round and then just attach it into its little nubbin hole there. So it'll just dry with it and hold in place. Take your time, just get that texture on. And if you do splodge onto the stonework, just tidy up with some paint after. There we are, with all that texture now applied and the Wretchling put in place, we're ready to start applying a shade. Now for this we'll be using aggressive shade and apply it all over the base, including the stone and the texture. So I'm just going to grab a medium layer brush for this, just for a bit more control. Apply a little bit to palettes, just so I don't overload the brush too much. And then we're ready to start applying it. So all I'm going to do is just start coating that over and just working my way around. Take your time, try not to let it pull too much on that stonework. With that shade now thoroughly dry on the base, what we're going to do now is move on to highlighting the base. And for this, we'll be using Carrick Stone and we'll be doing a dry brush. So I'm going to get a small dry brush, medium or larger too much. So small is perfect because you can get around all those little details. So what I'm going to do is just load up the brush like so. And I'm just going to start rubbing it off onto the actual tissue paper. Now, the point of this is to remove as much of that pigment as possible from the bristles, but still maintain a little bit on the actual bristles themselves. So what I'm going to do is just move to the side. That's perfect. So there's still a little bit on there. What I'm going to do now is then just start flicking that back and forth between the stone and the dirt. So as you see, as I go back and forth like so, it's starting to actually pick out those raised areas. Just do this across all the stone and the mud. And there we are, with the model now painted and based, Fecula Flyblown and her Wurmspat are ready to head off into the beast grave to spread pestilence and disease. Now there are a couple of things to remember when painting this model. Firstly, when doing any highlighting, always maintain a nice sharp point to your brush. If you do find it splaying, just dip into some water and use your fingers to get it to a nice point. Also, when using shades and contrast, try not to overload your brush as it can quickly run out of control. If you do find this happening, just use that brush to soak up any excess. And also worth remembering when using any metallic paints as well, it's worth having a separate pot of water or just changing your water when you've done, because you don't want to contaminate your other paints with metallic flecks. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Hope you enjoy painting your own Wurmspat Warband, and we'll see you again soon. Bye bye.